there. There's another one that goes on this side.
And what's that?
Well, these are maneuvering points.
Okay.
Where if you need to change the angle of the cannon, guys could put a chain through that or even through this and over through that.
Okay.
And move the back end a little bit.
Yeah.
So, you know, this is basic blacksmithing here. Come around here, I'll show you.
Okay.
So, we do not have any electric welding here or any gas welding. The welding we do here is the old style forge welding.
Right.
This is about as fancy as I get in this shop.
So that's pretty fancy. Yeah.
And what was your name?
Jack Hurley.
Jack Hurley.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. We got a lot of.
So we have the.
Decked out.
We have good equipment, good anvil, a real good vise over here, the forge, and it's a bellows driven forge.
Mm-hmm.
It's a two chamber bellows. I don't have it running right now.
Yeah.
The bottom chamber fills the top chamber. And the top chamber keeps a continuous flow going into the fire as long as I'm pumping. And I can change the volume of the flow by changing the amount of weight on top.
Right.
So I've got 3 bricks on it right now, or 2.5. That's about as much as I ever use.
Yeah. Now, I guess you use coal?
Yeah.
For
we
heating
use
up?
Metallurgical grade coal.
Yeah.
Which is very low in sulfur.
Mm-hmm.
And it forms coke. And we put the coal on the fire, literally dripping wet. I know, it's counterintuitive, but we do. And it steams itself into coke.
Okay.
So then as and notice I save a lot of the fuel from the last fire.
Yeah.
So that's what I start my fire with.
Makes it easier to start, doesn't
it? Oh, much.
Yeah.
And then I put the wet coal on top. And as that coal gets exhausted, I can move the now coked coal down into the fire and put some more on top.
Yeah.
To give you an idea of how fluid this stuff is once you get it up to 2,000 degrees, I start with a railroad spike, wind up with a meat turner.
Oh.
That's all one railroad spike.
Wow. The whole piece is one railroad strike.
Yeah.
That's amazing. Pretty good.
These two utensils, the fork and the spoon, each came out of a piece that looked exactly like that.
Just a flat piece?
That's it. That's what I started with.
Wow. That's amazing.
This chain was made here. One of the men who was working here was working on his forge welding skills.
Uh-huh.
So I made the first foot or so, and he made the rest of it. But each link is forge welded.
Wow, each link. Ends.
It's a lap and then just fused together.
That's interesting.
So I assume you've probably heard about the Revolutionary War remains that they found up at the
I don't think he's up on that. I know a little bit about it.
Okay, so they found these 14 remains. Gosh, now it must have been 6 or 8 months ago.
Mm-hmm.
12 of them were clearly on the revolutionary side. Of course, you know that was a losing battle for the for the colonists. So these 12 were just tumbled into 3 holes. You know, no proper burial at all.
Mm-hmm.
Only about 8 inches of dirt on top of them.
Well,
3 of them were 15 years old or younger.
Mm.
So we know. Actually, they found scraps of their clothing, which was blue, woolen, and they found their brass buttons. And it was a unit that came from Maryland and Delaware.
Mm-hmm.
And it was one of the first units in American history to have USA on the buttons.
Yeah, that's
it was,
neat.
It was just the I've USA that, was a brand new
car. That was a intertwined
I don't
letters.
Know. I haven't seen,
I think I've seen the USA.
Okay. So... The other two, one was a Fraser Highlander, and again, they can tell by the buttons.
Right.
This was a crack UK unit. came from Scotland, but mm-hmm. They were fighting for the British. The other was a British, was an American loyalist who was fighting on the British side. And we know that because they were given a much more proper burial. You know, each in one grave with their hands up like this.
Mm-hmm.
But, so, all of them were taken down to the forensic lab at the University of South Carolina.
Where?
And they've done DNA on them.
Yeah.
And you can now go on 23andMe and see if one of them was somewhere back in your background. So, on the 20th, I'm not sure exactly when this is. You need to check, but maybe on the 19th, there's going to be a big parade downtown.
Mm-hmm.
And by the way, that cannon will participate in the parade. That's why we're getting it ready.
That's nice.
Yeah, yeah. Our woodworker, Philip Holtgren, did the woodwork, even made the wheels and the hubs. And 2 weeks ago, we shrank those iron tires onto the wheels.
Oh.
We built a big fire out and back and heated them and expanded them.
So when it cooled, it shrunk down?
And yeah, you have a hose ready to cool them down.
Wow.
And they even have a videotape of it.
That is neat.
It really worked. It just drew up and drew those wheels together.
Yeah.
So anyway, that's the downtown part. Then everything's going to be brought out here,
uh-huh.
I'm sure in trucks. And they're going to lie in state for a couple of days at the Kershaw house, the big house up here.
Okay.
And then on Sunday the 22nd, they'll be in a procession through Camden here, out up to uptown to the Presbyterian Church. Mm-hmm. There'll be a service up there. Then everything will be loaded on trucks and taken within about a mile of the battlefield.
Mm-hmm.
Unloaded, and there will be a full procession to the battlefield, and they'll be reinterred.
Oh, that'll be
in
something.
Proper 18th century caskets, made, you know, like that.
Yeah.
And made with some antique, full 1-inch wide pine board, 1-inch thick and, gosh, 14 inches wide boards that we got from a store that was being torn down up in town.
Mm-hmm.
And everything held together with handmade nails, which were made right here.
All right.
Mostly by me.
Yeah.
Now, that's a big nail like that takes me about 100 blows to make. It took about 30 nails per coffin. There's 14 coffins.
Uh-huh.
So I made around 620 nails.
Well, that's something you'd be proud of.
Yep. Yep. I felt real good about it. This is the hammer I used for all of that.
Yeah.
2 kilograms. Check it out.
Whoa, that's pretty. What is that, about 3 pounds?
4.4.
Well, that'll wear you out.
Not if you
build your arm
since up. 1972.
Yeah, you get your arm built up to it.
Hello, Matthew. Come and see me. F.J. Hurley at the historic Camden Park in the blacksmith shop.
Okay.